he pointed out to malnutrition accounting for stunted growth, especially in the Wenzo region. 15% of children are stunted. And then it also has to do with gender issues. He's saying 10% of women are undernourished. And then and some of the causes for this food insecurity, okay, for low levels of food security, environmental degradation, the pests which are a threat to food crops, and then also other issues like low adoption to measures aimed at addressing climate change. Maybe from there we can learn, we can have lessons from Kenya.
Thank you very much, Cubs, Abalimi, Webalimno, for this opportunity to share with you some few experiences from Kenya. I would start by way of introduction of the general food security situation in Kenya. In Kenya, I would say food security is sufficient, not sufficient, so-so. The issues that we have really are the same from what has been presented for this particular area. We have challenges in terms of adoption of technologies by farmers. Climate change is really a world over challenge. The rainfall patterns have definitely changed, and so farmers are affected on when and what to do, what with the land. We also have challenges in terms of pests and diseases that are affecting, especially emerging pests and diseases affecting farmers, and definitely gender. Gender is an issue even in Kenya. Now, gender presents in different perspectives. For example, issues of ownership of land, who owns the land, and therefore will decide what will be planted where. Generally, men, our culture is a lot of it is patriarchal, and so men own the land, and therefore they will say, I'm going to do sugarcane on 99% of land, leaving very little for any other food crop. And so that affects the nutritional status of children and women, and even the men themselves. There's even issues of culture, really gender and culture you cannot separate. So that when you have brought food on the table, there is what a woman cannot eat, and what children cannot eat, and what men should eat. And that affects definitely the nutritional status. And I see that comparing really the same as what has been presented. So I would say really the situation of food security is basically the same, and especially the issues that we face and how we are able to try and mitigate. For example, we work very closely with the line ministries to be able to look at what you can do to control pests and diseases, and issues of accessing farmers to certified seed, which is very important. We had our traditional ways of having seed available, but now looking at the differences in climate and soil that has been used for so long, there is need to access certified seed, and therefore various land ministries and as well as research institutes access seed to farmers. Issues of gender are really not something that you sort out in a day. You keep on having dialogue with the farmers, so that when we are going to train the farmers to be able to uptake a particular technology, you also have discussions on gender for men and women to realize that there should be equity in terms of ownership of land. There should be discussions around what should be grown on the land, and even access to the market and income. Finally, utilizing the income, there should be some sort of discussion and understanding between the men and women. So definitely in Kenya, the situation is just about the same. And we also, you know, collaborate with partners to be able to address and improve food security situation.